This happened after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created Hawa. Hawa was also created as the author and then the quotations. Even the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in one of his quotations explained this sort of thing. Meaning Allah created Adam and then he brought his what? His companion out of him. وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ أَنْ خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَنْفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا إِذَا لَا يُوجَدُ السَّكِينَ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا يُوجَدُ السَّكِينَ فِي الْحَيَاةِ إِلَّا حَيَاةِ زَوْجَيْهِ There is no comfort. There is no solace. There is no tranquility. There will be no peace. مُكَيْ كَدِلِ بَارَ يُوَا مِنْ كَوْ مُكَيْ غَوْرُونِ If you are a bachelor holder, you will never get the blessing. So Allah, you will never get, you know, comfort. You never get solace. Wouldn't you have been kama wahala ni? Ngana tafia chinga ni kama kada girma. No dignity for you. So these sort of things, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after having called for the respect of his creator to mankind, who is going to be the president of the earth, he then said, Now get in and dwell in the Jannah, you and your wife. Uskun anta wa zawjuka al-Jannah. But there is a condition over here. This place is a place of enjoyment. There will be no enjoyment with the what? With the disobedience of Allah. No matter whatever you have, no matter what money you have, what position you have, if you are a rebel and you are disobey Allah for comfort as we say comfort in its what term you will never get it ba duba mutum komin sarautar shi komin girman shi har dai mai sabon Allah ne abinda ake kira jin daji wanda Allah ya aje ake kira jin daji ba shi ku ke ganin sarakai da kenan da ba musulmai ba ko suna jin daji wallahi suna cikin wahala ba su kwana ba su cikin kwanciyar hankali amma wanda ke tsoron Allah in yayi kwana yayi kwana ne in ya tashi kuma ya tashi amma kana cikin tsoron Allah you are in a great panic so this place is a place of enjoyment is a place of comfort there is a condition ya adam uskun anta wazawjuka aljanna amma wala taqrabu hadhihi ash-shajara فَكُلَا حَيْثُ شِئْتُمَا Dwell in and then eat from every corner whatever you want. Eat everything. وَلَا تَقْرَبَ هَذِهِ الشَّجَرَةِ Don't come close to this particular tree. That is the commandment. That is the condition of living here. This particular tree, don't touch it. فَتَكُونَ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ If you do that, you will be among those who deceive and cheat their own soul. So cheating or disobedience or disbelief, you are not doing or committing something against somebody. It's not committing against Allah, but Allah, you are committing what? A disbelief against your own soul. You are cheating your own soul because the repercussion is very bad. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala having got them dead and dwelled them into that, Usher them into Jannah. Over there, for waswas alone by Shaitan. Satan tried and lured them. What happened to them? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has covered them with noon, with light. In another term, they are saying with zafar. There was in every condition, there is a garment, there is a horizon. That one can live. So in that place, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has covered, they are naked. They are naked. But they don't see that they are naked because they are being covered with the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that's why we said yesterday that if you obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you are covered and safe. And if you disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you are naked and unsafe. You are in danger. So above Allah, danger. Rashin sabon Allah kuma safety ne in baka sabon Allah ba Allah ya kiyaye ka ya baka lada kamar yadda wani ke fani wai riga garment wanda ke kiyaye mutum shine tsoron Allah shine suron Allah libasin taqwa. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has covered them, but when they committed sin against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Satan lured them liyubtiya lahuma, in order to what? To cast out liyubhira ma wuriya anhuma ay ma sutira anhuma. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has covered them, so he lured them to touch something that will cover them. Min sawatihima, from their nakedness. Awratihima. Waqala, he said, you know why I'm advising you? Mana hantuma rabbukuma. Allah, I'm going to tell you something. Remember, he said, waqasamahuma. Waqasamahuma. He swear. We are coming to it. I swear that. You know why you don't have that decision? If you touch it and eat, you're not going to die. You won't die. And then you are going to continue to be what? To be living. You are going to be mortal. These two things are something that is instinctively into mankind. Hada fitra, fitra al insan. Hubbul baqa wa hubbul shara. Hubbul baqa wa hubbul shara. I want to be the leader. I want to be this. I want to be that. Kakache mga mangashina. Mkachaka wanka mkani wanka mungu. Shikina. You don't want to die, and then you will do what? And then you will be an elevated person, dignified person. These two points is what the Satan used, because he got it instinctively into mankind, into Adam. But Adam did not get convinced easily just because of that. Now, I've been there, sir. Yes, I'm Adam. Chile me. He swear. And they also believe that when you swear in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then it means you are not going to stop something which is wrong. He did that, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blamed them. He said that, why did you touch what I asked you and what I warned you not to touch? Why did you go in? Haven't I advised you? Haven't I cautioned you? Haven't I told you? Adam and Hakuma and Tilkuma Shajara? Haven't I denied you? Haven't I prevented you from not touching this particular tree? Wa aqul lakuma, and haven't I told you? Inna shaytana lakuma adu mubin. Adam, I've already told you. From day one, from when I asked them to salute, over there he shows, and he calls for respite, as we read in Surah As-Sad. He said Allah should give him time, so that he will get time to live. He didn't even stop that. He tried when Allah cast him out from the place, he lived and entered and followed Adam in order to draw Adam from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Over there, Adam and Hawa committed this sort of thing. That is where we ended yesterday. So we are going to continue from Quran chapter 23. When that happened, what did Allah say, or what did the Quran tell us? Kala. When that happened, they realized this is the nature of Adam. This is the nature of Adam. Immediately, a taraf, he recognized and then what? Accepted that I have committed something wrong. Even though we don't call this particular thing as a thumb, because Adam was lured by what? Being sworn in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He didn't go there just, he wanted to sin. Come on, yende yon muke mu. Adam ba wo yaka ba bende yon mu. Ya so yi khala ba ma Allah ba ni. La, kudu wa hende da kabide shi. Ya me raswa, ya kudde shi. Ya ke ya me wana, ya yi kada kada. Wada da wane, kai kwa ba haka ki zwa, zumbi ki zwa ba kaba. Kai da zumbi ya zo ga ba ne, mani ba one condition, ba ba ka komi ba shi ka fada shi. Sabo da shi ba kira wanga na Adam ga zumbi. saboda matsayin su da Allah subhanahu wataala ya aje shi. Akwai maganganu da yawa na maluma wanda suka ce zunubi ne, wanda suka ce abin nan ne. Amma me zunubi wurin manyan mutane, wurin masu bautar Allah, kuskure su ana kiran shi zunubi. Kuskure when they committed a mistake, we call it zunub. But their mistake is what? Their mistake is like the thumb that you have done. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us. So over there, they didn't become arrogant. They didn't continue to go against Allah. Over there, they raise up their hands and they say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, zalamna anfusana. We have actually deceived ourselves. Wa in lam taghfir lana. Allah, if you don't forgive us, wa tarhamna, and then shower your mercy upon us, lanakunanna min al-khasirin. Verily, we shall going to be among the what? The losers. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. Look at the two situations, the two scenarios. We will look at the comparison later. Look at the two scenarios. This one committed a sin, and he said, Allah, give me time to continue committing my sin. And this one committed a sin, and he said, Allah, I have forgiven. Allah, help me to go out of it. Condition biyunga, when you are in the yace a bashi hanya ya ci mugun shi, wanda ya yi mugun shi ya fahimci kamar ya yi mugun, ya nufi Allah ya yafe mai, don Allah abu biyun ga ciki wa ke da kyau ke kuma jawabi wane ne na kirki. To kun ga jawabin shi na jiya da nake ce na jawabin gwawanci na ya zo ko bai zo ba, ai ya ce da yake bai zo, ya ce ana khairun min khalaqtani min tin, khalaqtani min nar wa khalaqtahu min tin. Ashe bai sani ba, kuma na gaya muku kamar tinin nan abinda ake kira ci gaba, abinda ake kira rayuwa, abinda ake kira mai development, abinda ake kira progress asalin shi kenan. Amma abinda ake kira distraction yau, kowane abu za a yi na distraction lokacin wuta ya fito. Kuriya mbombu ne wuta ne, in mizazi ne wuta ne, in drone ne wuta ne, in menene wuta ne, wanga za ka zo kana rigima da shi. To gashi nan wannan da ya kuskure ya ce Allah ya fahimi, wannan da ya kuskure ya ce Allah ba ni lokaci, ba ni sarauta, ba ni karfi, ya so cigaba cikin muguwan kina. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. When Adam subhanahu wa ta'ala, when Adam said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, forgive me, even let us try to understand something here, brother. Let us take a lesson out of here. Even Adam did not know how to seek for forgiveness. It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who taught him. We shall come to that in another surah. Here he said that, Rabbana zalamna anfusana. Oh Allah, we have cheated ourselves, lied ourselves, eluded ourselves. We have deceived ourselves. Faghfir lana. Allah, if you don't forgive us and you don't shower your mercy on us, we shall be among the losers. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said,
قَالَ اَمْبِرُوا بَعْضُكُمْ لِبَعْضٍ عَدُوٌّ وَلَكُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ مُسْتَقَرٌّ وَمَتَاعٌ إِلَى حِينٍ.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, اِحْبِتُوا, get out of this place, بَعْدُكُمْ لِبَعْدٍ عَدُوٌّ. You Iblis and your family, and Adam, your wife and your family, you are going to be enemies from now onwards. You will be trying to obey Allah, and then the Satan and his family will try to distract you, dissuade you, refer you, cast you out, turn you away, put challenges, put obstacles before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's will has a promise. So you are going to be enemies on the earth. وَلَكُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ مُسْتَقَرٌ. You are going to be on the earth. You are going to dwell there. مُسْتَقَرٌ وَمَتَاعٌ, and then to enjoy إِلَى حِينٍ إِلَى حِينٍ إِلَى وَقْتٍ مَعْلُومٍ, up to the time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has appointed. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about the surah Adam on this earth. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, on this earth that you are going to dwell, now what is going to
happen?
On this earth is your dwelling place. Where are you going to enjoy? you are going to live in it. وفيها تموتون and die in it. ومنها تخرجون and then you will be also resurrected one day out of this place. As he says something, منها خلقناكم on this earth. Brethren, we shall take a lesson out of it later. منها خلقناكم on this dust of clay that I have created you. وفيها نعيدكم. We shall send you back also on this earth. ومنها نخرجكم. And we resurrect you back تارة أخرى another day. So that is what ولكم في الأرض مستقر ومتاع إلى حين. Allahu Akbar. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, on this earth you are going to live, on this earth you are going to die, and then be put in the earth, and then be brought in out one day. This is the story of Adam in Surah Al-A'raf. Let us look at the ta'kibat on the story, the conclusions on the story, the remarks on the story. If you look at Surah Al-A'raf, you will see that it has some parts that has been mentioned which has not been mentioned in Surah Al-Saad. أنها تشمل على جزئيات كثيرة لم تذكر في سورة الصاد. ففي سورة الصاد ذكر الماء والتين. Allah mentioned the clay, he mentioned the water, ولكنه لم يذكر في سورة الأعراف. This is the comparison that you learn if you are following us, if you are going with us. وفي سورة الصاد ذكر القول ولكنه لم يذكر في سورة ذكر القول بعنوان الربوبية. وإذ قال ربك الله سبحانه وتعالى mention in سورة but here he said what إذ ولكن في سورة الأعراف he said what ثم قلنا meaning look at it. إذ قال ربك, this is the reason why we started with سورة الصاد, we didn't start with this. So there is a link. There is a link between the story. Remember when I said this. Then, when he came to join the story, he said, then, ثُمَّ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَ. That is how Surah Al-A'raf started. So we are joining the story. So this is how it should go. You shouldn't start from the Baqarah. Baqarah is the end of the story. Because there are some things that will give us lessons of everything. It is in Baqarah. And you see that the fashion and the design of the surah, of the divine novel, will take up its what? Absolute completion in that. So that is it. وفي الأعراف, in Surah Al-A'raf, Quran chapter 7, he said, ذكر الأمر. He mentioned command. إذ أمرتك ولم يذكر خلق باليدين الذي ذكر في الصلاة. The same thing also here, he said that ما منعك أن تسجد لما خلقت بيدين. That is in another surah. But here ما منعك أن تسجد ألا تسجد إذ أمرتك. So here he mentioned the command and here he did not mention the command. وكذلك أمرهما أن يأكلا من كل شيء إلا شجرة واحدة. وهذا في سورة الصاد. He told them that they should eat everything. وكيف وسوس لهما الشيطان حتى أكلا في الشجرة حتى أكلا من الشجرة وبدت لهما سوآتهما وطفقا يحصفان عليهما من ورق الجنة. فهذه هي مشاهد الموجودة في سورة الأعراف لم يذكر في سورة الصاد. This is the comparison. Now let us stand on the lessons. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, before we come to Surah, today we are entering in Surah Al-Taha. If you look at it, you will see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has molded Adam, dignified Adam, without anything. He didn't know all of this. And then he also became the servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Satan, who has not been given that position because of anger, because of selfishness, because of ananiya, anger, listen carefully, anger. Yesterday we talked about it on the member, anger. He was angry. Who is angry? You are only angry because you are what? This disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anytime you find yourself angry means you are a disobedient of Allah, because Allah said that you should what? You should exercise patience. He was angry for not being elevated in that position, so he went in and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cast him out of this. Anytime also, he also said, I'm going to what? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I'm going to fight tooth and nail. If an Englishman say tooth and nail, means every corner I will come from before them, I will come behind them, I will come on their left, I will come on their right, and I will not turn them. When I was talking about this thing, it reminds me of what is happening today to the youth on this earth. Wallahi, Satan is luring you. Satan is disturbing people. Has it not been Ramadan that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has what? Has tied up Satan. We will never find anybody here. I know there is a program in this mosque after Ramadan. Don't you give lessons, Malik, right? How many people come? They don't come. This is Satan. Baba, talk about you. I want to rescue you. You are in the bondage of Satan. Let me rescue you. Kuna chikin me, Satan ya dawde yu. Ya ya alkawali ina saboda shi kuma dokin sura kuma dokin kisan annabi Adam muyi karatu da shi mu samu lesson ciki sai ta ya dau alkawali wai ba zai yadda ku samu rahman nan da Allah ya hana shi ba zo faran mata ya zo gaban ya zo bayan ya zo dama ya zo hauni yana yin kuwa kana da clearly good man kana sabon Allah idan good man sallan kirki in kaje ka zauna gaban yaron ka da kyar ka sawo ga yaran nan da kyar ga mu cikin wata azumi an daura shaitani na shi ya facilitate maka ka zo kana zaune nan ga ya biyo ka nan ya biyo ka nan yau gashi nan kan phone ka ba irin sabo Allah da bai on your phone somebody be jabin kariya nake yi we are not dealing with you so phone ka sabo Allah nan ba wai really kamar bin an kai wanda shi an rude shi ne aka ce mai gaban kaka sabi Allah sabi Allah amma nayi rantsuwa sabu da nace kai ga abin da zai yi kai naka ba haka bane kan phone ka non chat ka ba log in to this site and have fun with me ko ba ba this what is happening on your phones log in to this site and have fun na gane da shi ce maka ba na gane guda guda ruwa da ya sanar kowa we log in to 4248 and have fun Allah ki aka ka log in ka ga jahannama iri iri wurin kuma za ka yi ka zo kan Facebook wa ma adraka ma Facebook yau ban nan jewa da ke tafiya cikin gari ga doctor mai yaran in ji a sance ce kaman we wuce da ana unan gua wanting what is them ana unan gua wanting you think that you have what you are safe you have protected yourself but let me tell you you are what you are cast into danger why am I saying that all your youth your children you are sleeping and in the night your daughter and your son is logging out with somebody on the Skype and getting fun. Somebody says, you don't have an excuse, Baba, where is happening? You don't like how to hold the zaman in. You should be up and doing. Here what I'm not doing, and you have to come out of the English. In that case, we have a phone, because I'm calling the English. You have to come out of the Ashi, and then they say, the Sora of Mubu Aduka. Phone the Kihani, you have to go to Ashi. So people must say, eh? Imam? Yeah, that's not a phone, pass the phone. Kasan tsaje ya gida su duka kowa ya bubbude ya sunan shi account cikin Facebook. What I did was ni ke bude ma shi Facebook na bude Sheikh Hakish na zauni da shi kana wani abin ka duka da kayi abin nan ya notify ni kan nawa ya notify gare wa ina magana shi na duba na yana duba shi na duba na mai abin ka ne la nace mai kaman ku ba ku sa abu ba ku sa abu you are not lucky. When I was young I used to yell my father Allah ya fi ni na yanzu in ce ma baba na kaman za ni sayi buku sunan buku na geography mun geography dai saboda baba na bai tesu ba kamin sa ji Allah ya fi ni amma ni na tesu ba ku yara ha na tesu da shi ba ku zo ka ce ni geography this for that matter, the responsibility is more dangerous than responsibility in that.
All those of you who are in school, who have the talent of writing, kaje ka rubuta mini kissat adam fil qur'an in your own way na baka kai novel ka kawo cikin gari an samu amfani ka samu kudi sannan kuma ka abin nan na bude makofa ko bude makofa ba an bude makofa those of you are school those realities and what not inshallah may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us let us go into that surah and read together as usual surah al-baha quran chapter 115. Everybody should take his Quran, inshallah. Yes. I like what I've been seeing here. Yeah, our Imam is very current. When I say take your Quran, then I'll do that. You take his phone, there's a Quran on it. MashaAllah, MashaAllah. You don't have an excuse. They are current. Aka ta Quran ko wani gari ne shi Quran kenan abinda muke so kenan I use modern gadget about to Allah ne shi so shi sabari da muke rike da phone ko nan da yake kai ka fita fito tin mata nan kun fito tin mata nan ka sa Quran kai ha abi ana su my friend do you have one on your phone good abi remove the WhatsApp and all this inshallah Quran chapter
15 Masha'Allah. Shall we read?
Can we go with the meaning? Inshallah, because of the time. Read it again. With Adam before when was that we shall look at it later when was that before we took a covenant with Adam ahidna awsalna al-ma'lumat ila Adam ahidna ila Adam indeed we made a covenant with Adam before but he forgot fanasiya now walam najid lahu azma and we found on his part no firm will power no firm will power لم يكن له ثبات ولا تصلب لم يتصلب للعزم لم نجد له عزم upon all the covenant that we gave Adam Adam could not stand it لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله نعم
وإذ قلنا للملائكة اسجدوا لآدم فسجدوا إلا إبليس أبى
قلنا للملائكة اسجدوا لآدم فسجدوا إلا إبليس أبى
And remember, when we sent angels, prostrate yourself to Adam, they all prostrated themselves, except Iblis. He refused to do that. Why did he refuse to do that? Why did he refuse to do that? Go back to the other surah that we read. He already said out of pride that Allah, why should I prostrate to somebody who is below me? Below you? Allah created you and Allah created him. How can you be below? Allah knows what is the best. And Allah wanted you to be the best and then he made the source the best. So the thing is the best, subhanAllah. So he refused. And what happened?
فَقُلْنَا يَا آدَمُ إِنَّ هَذَا عَدُوٌّ لَكَ وَلِزَوْجِكَ فَلَا يُخْرِجَنَّكُمَا مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ فَتَشْقَى
Then we said to Adam, O Adam, verily this is an enemy to you,
and to your wife. This is an enemy to you and your wife. I want you to be observing something before we come to the explanation. We are now taking the meaning. When we come to explanation, you see that the message here is directed to Adam, 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 Adam. And that is going to what? That is going to rescue Hawa from the blame people are putting on Hawa. It is the blame that has been put on Hawa that brought other religions today on the earth. We didn't get Christianity, but the what? The tale they are talking about Adam. We didn't get other religions, the tale they are talking about Adam and Hawa. Because they are saying that it is Hawa who brought the reason why Adam was brought on the earth. But from the earth, from the Quran itself, Allah has rescued him. Surah Al-Taha is there. You will see that the message is always over there. He said that Fakula, Idhaba, and all this thing. By here, the message is directing to Adam. That means the mantle and the power and the authority is whose hand? Whose hand? It's Adam. So if you blame, you rather blame Adam, not go and blame Hawa. From day one, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to create, he said that I'm going to create. I'm going to create man from this and bring him on earth. When قلنا للملائكة when قال ربك للملائكة إني جائل في الأرض from day one في الأرض خليفة قالوا أتجعل فيها من يفسد فيها ويسفك الدماء. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not because Adam committed sin or Adam did something or Adam went wrong, that's why Allah brought him on the earth. From day one Allah wanted to bring him on the earth. He was repeating it. Even the verse that we finished, he repeated it. فيها تحيونا وفيها تموتونا ومنها تخرجون. That's the earth. The shiba we won't move on the day. Yes, I'll call shiba. Kala rasu. Nadekina. Nebu. And the message here is telling that the message is going to Adam, Adam. So it is Adam. If there's somebody to be blamed, you should blame Adam. Don't go and blame Hawa. Hawa is what? Is under Adam. Allah wa ta'ala. So Allah is rescuing him. He said that. Now. فقلنا يا آدم إن هذا عدو لك. Oh Adam, verily this is an enemy to you and your wife and your family. So let him not get both of you out of this place, out of this enjoyable place, so that you will be distressed. There is going to be distress. I'm putting you here, Adam, for you to get comfort. I've already told you. Ba comfort, ba jin daji nke gauroni. Ba jin daji she nke gauroni. Eh, katuna lokacin da kake rayuwa. Sometimes man nan ce kana da kudi, ma kana da kudi lokacin da baka yi aure ba, kana da kudi an nuka sosai. Kore ba ba, kana da lafiya sosai. Amma for you to enjoy life, she da wani kusa ne kusa da kai. Amma duk da haka wannan ta zama wanda za ta kawo maka comfort nan ta zo kuma, she kai ma Allah girman kai, baka da wanda kare na kuma she ita. Baka da wanda kare na she matanka, matankan nan kuma in ba ta nan kuma ba daɗin rayuwa, in ba ta nan ba abin nan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ga wurin jin daɗi, amma da ya san jin daɗi zai cika, she da two companion. Saboda shi mutum ya zama wawa, bai samun lafiya, ya sa bai samun distress when he log out to something else. Inda za ka ga wawancin waɗansu da ke kira kansu wai gay, waɗansu wawaye da ke kira kansu wai lesbian. This language is, we must fight it and we must talk against it from every corner. Wanda ba batun wani, batun wani right, wani bane da menene, wanda ya zama maki Allah duka, you should fight it from any corner inda zaka bi. In baka yi ba, kai kuma ka zama enemy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ka zama enemy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Da shi inda aka samu gay, inda aka samu lesbian, gurin duka ya kamata ka yi me, ka nisanci waɗannan ababa da ke da tattare da shi duka. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ya ce mai kamar me zai zamo mai ya ce ma Adam, ka doki wannan makiyinka kenan da kai da matanka, amma hey, a kul zan gaya maka, fala yukhrijannakuma karku yadda Allah ya halice ka Adam Allah ya halice shaytan ya fi ka sanin shaytan Allah ai Adam na fi ka sanin ka na san wani abu da ke tare da kai na san hanyar da za a bi a ruje ka amma Adam ina gaya maka kar ka yadda falla yukhrijannakuma min aljanna أي فلا يخرجنكما من مكان المتاع إننا أجيه وزونا وجدادي كربو يجع هذا الذي في دفو فتشقى لوكة الزاق وحلع فالمراش What we say is that then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said verily this is an enemy to you and your wife I created you Adam and I know you and I created Satan and I know him And I know instinctively where Satan could touch and lure you. When he touched there, he will get you. So I'm cautioning you. I am forewarning you, Adam. Don't allow him to remove you from the enjoyable place I've placed you. Here, it is easy go place. In American language, it is easy go place. You are not going to work. You are not going to suffer. You're not going to this thing. I'm going to let you stay here and enjoy. Back Aiki. Fufide. Aljanna. If you want fried rice, is there. If you want grilled chicken, is there. If you want grilled fish. I'm going to go to the house. I'm going to go to the house. I'm going to go to the house. I think that the carrier is okay.